come to pass. Okay, hey, the Lord's bringing out that spirit of prophecy, man. We are here prophesying death and destruction unto the wicked, man. All right, boldly. And the wicked run this society, man. All right, you get him? But don't worry about that. Just get her the one I called for 2 Corinthians 10. To get me Ephesians 6 chapter. Second, you got to be spiritual, man. This is a spiritual battle, man. You can't be all into yourself being carnal, man. We ain't got Babylon under no physical siege, man. It's a spiritual siege. And the elites, they can feel the pressure, man. The spirits are fucking with them, man. All up in their dreams. These people are getting messed up in the spirit. All them people that was up here, when the brother proclaimed the name of Yahweh, Shammi Abashai, I saw many people scatter, man.
Yeah.
They scattered for the spirit of the Lord, man. Them demons fled. Hey, the Lord's dealing with us, man. And Yahweh Shammi Abashai is the true power, man.
That was made
evident today that the angels are surrounding us, man. That's why you got you pussies on the comic board. Okay, you guys are meant to be big bad boy Benjamites coming on the comic board, bomb buckle out this and blood clot that. You ain't got the nerve to come out here on the streets.
That's
man.
Right!
Because the Lord ain't dealing with you, man. You're a bunch of scared pussies, man. You ain't got Babylon on the siege on the comic boards. The Spirit of the Lord ain't dealing with you, man. Okay? Go on, man.
So 2 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
The scripture says the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, man. We ain't gonna come out here, like the brother said, with machetes. First of all, we come out here and start beat, which we probably beat up a lot of you weak pussies real quick. But you know, so many of you, man, you know, just gonna get mocked on, you know? We ain't gonna really take down Babylon. You know what I'm saying?
There's so many of you, man.
Yeah. Even a 1,000 pussies will take you out. You understand what I'm saying? We come out here and start getting into fights with the riffraff, rolling around on the floor, that ain't gonna get us nowhere. Babylon is still gonna stand firm. Okay, you gotta destroy the spiritual foundations, man. Hey, and it's even like that really spiritually in boxing, man. They try to get at a man. If you take out a man's spirit, he ain't gonna win that fight, man. They go and bring
Tyson, he said he looks until he comes into the ring and he just brings the guy in the eye and look into his soul. Because your eyes are the windows of the soul. And he takes his soul, of his contender through his eyes, man. He said, what?
That's right. Hey, because it's a spiritual thing. Well, the thing is, if we came out here, like the brother mentioned, them two Nigerian donuts, which they're probably agents anyway, they went and tried to chop some cracker's head off, that ain't going to take down Babylon. There's loads more where that little cracker came from. That's not going to upset Babylon. This is what's upsetting Babylon. This is what is destroying Babylon. Every time we come out here and we teach this word, Babylon gets destroyed, man. Them demons are groaning, man. The foundations of this place are shaking, man. All right? That's why we don't come out here and fight. We come out here and bring these scriptures. We pull out the spiritual sword, man. But these people don't understand spiritual warfare, man. Okay, go on.
But are you sure this script is correct?
Yes, I'm 100% sure.
How?
How? What would you mean, how?
Like, how? Who printed? Where is it printed? Where was it printed?
Hey, CEO Carnal, this ain't about the printed words. It's about the spirit.
Yeah, we are in 2015.
This book no is a spirit, man. Sure. Listen. This book ain't paper and ink, man. If you can't understand that, then guess what? The Lord ain't dealing with you. This is a spiritual thing that existed. Listen. Before there was ink, give me John 1. Before there was paper and ink, this word existed, man.
Right.
That's what these stupid ass Muslims don't get. This ain't about paper and ink. This is a spiritual thing.
I'm not Muslim.
I don't care if you are or not. I don't care if you are or not. I'm using them as an example.
I ask you a simple question.
Well, I'm giving you a simple answer.
Do you think this is right? You think
this is the right?
What are Muslims hearing between you and me?
This is not just about you, man. I don't give a damn about you.
Man, I'm a history man.
This is John 1:1.
And you ain't got your peaceful man. You ain't gonna make it.
Answer me.
You ain't gonna make it, man.
Answer me by noise.
In the beginning.
Inside you don't have. Inside you don't have anything.
In the beginning.
You are empty.
Move on. Your head is empty, man. You bald ass motherfucker.
This is John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word.
The Word was in the beginning. This Word is spiritual, man. People get caught up on paper and ink. You read it, you don't understand that it's spirit. Give me John. Hold what you got here, though. I want you to get me John. Was it 17 or the Word?
Six.
Yeah, get that real quick. Read that. Hey, he's going into the same thing. See, thank you, Satan. Satan came up, but it's still in the spirit, man. Go on.
John 1:1. In the beginning was the Word.
In the beginning was the Word. So when you go back to the Heavenly Father, which has no beginning and end, the Heavenly Father, at the beginning of His creation, the first thing He created was the Word, which is who the Word ignorantly calls Jesus Christ, man. Which, by the way, He wasn't a so-called white man with a blonde hair and blue eyes. He happened to be a so-called Negro with white woolly hair, man. And He was the first being ever created. Pursuing to the book of Colossians, the first chapter, man. He's the firstborn of every creature, man.
That's right.
And
that's
the express
right.
image of the Father.
That's right.
Our Bar Shem Yahweh,
that's right, man.
He ain't no creepy ass cracker.
And the Word was with the Most High.
The Word was with the Heavenly Father, man. The Yahweh Shai was with the Heavenly Father, man. From the beginning. Go on.
And the Word was the Most High.
Nah, it doesn't say that, bro. Read it, bro.
And the Word was God. The
Word was God, meaning Yahweh Shai was a power, man. He's a power underneath Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai, man. And He's going to show He's a power because He's going to come in power in His return. And you're going to stand there and tell me that He ain't a God, but He's a God under Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai. Okay? That's how you break that down. It don't mean that Yahweh Shai is the Most High, but He is a power. Okay?
It's John 6:63. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing.
The Spirit quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. Go on.
The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life.
They are spirit and they are life. Because guess what? How you know this book is spiritual, man? Because any asshole can pick up the Bible and read it, right? If it was just ink and paper, then anyone can pick up the Bible, start reading it, and get the understanding. But give me Revelations second. Where's scripture, man? What's that Revelation 3:19. Get Revelations 3:19.
Revelations 3:19.
Because the Word is Yahweh Shai. This is just pen and ink and paper, which are the words. But there's a spirit behind this book, man, that has always existed. Okay. So when you read this book, if the spirit ain't dealing with you, you ain't gonna have the understanding in this word, man. You're gonna be all bugged out your mind, because to you can read the Bible like a novel. But the Bible ain't a novel, it's a spiritual book. And if you're a spiritual, you'll get the spiritual understanding, man. Go on, you got that?
Revelation 3:19. And as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten. Be zealous therefore and repent. Behold.
The scripture said, be zealous therefore. You're supposed to be zealous for the name of Yahweh Bar Shem Yahweh Shai in this Bible, man. No, you people call yourself Christians, believe in the Bible. You're not zealous, man. You ain't zealous about nothing, man. You're of the world, man. You don't stand up for nothing that's right, man. The real Christians back in Rome, they were deemed a terrorist organization, man. Because they were causing riot, man. They stood up against the idolatry. They stood up against homosexuality. They stood up and they were prophesying the downfall of Rome. They didn't pray for Rome. Oh, Lord Jesus, please save Rome. They weren't doing that. They prayed that Rome was destroyed, that the kingdom of heaven may come into being. But if you ask these Christians about Rome or London, they'll say, yeah, pray for London. The hell you, yeah, pray that London gets destroyed. That's zealous, go on.
Right, it says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door.
Yeah, the voice is the men of the Lord speaking this word, which the spirit is likened unto wind. And when we're speaking, it's the wind, the breath. Go on.
Right. It says, open the door, I'll come into him.
The spirit will come into you. You know, this book ain't going to enter into your head physically. It's a spiritual thing. Go on.
and we'll sup with him.
And we'll sup with him, meaning the Lord's going to start opening up your mind to understand the words that are being spoken, man. And not everyone is going to understand this, man. You had a whole multitude of peons up there earlier, and all they could say was, what's this all about? What's going on? Because the Lord ain't dealing with them, man.
That's right.
The Lord ain't, they can't understand simple words, man.
That's right.
Because the Spirit, there's demons on them, blinding them from the truth. Lest they, if they're Israelites, lest they understand the truth and they repent and they be healed, man. But the Lord don't want 2/3 of our people to be healed, and he don't want you heathens to be healed, because you can't be healed. All you heathens, you so-called white people, you Japanese, Chinese, they're not white, they're red. They're not white, okay?
You're red.
Okay?
Yeah, okay.
They're red.
And what are we? Black?
Brown? No, we're people of color, we're brown.
Okay.
Okay, but we're really Israelites. That's why I say so-called, because really they're Edomites.
What's an Edomite?
An Edomite is a nation found in the Bible.
Okay.
Okay, it's a biblical nation. Anyone that descends from the biblical man called Esau is an Edomite, aka the devil that the Bible speaks of, the wicked of the earth.
So, if you're an Edomite,
yeah,
you're from the devil's place.
You are a devil. Oh. You're a deceiver. You're the seed of the wicked.
And where's that?
Get me on Malachi the first chapter. Okay?
See? I hope you don't think I'm taking it because I'm actually interested.
Well, you can ask the question. I'll answer the question.
Malachi 1 and 1. The burden of the word of the Lord to Israel by Malachi.
What?
I have loved you, saith the Lord. Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us?
That's talking about our people in the scriptures, the Israelites, so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, man. Because we're not niggers, we're not Afro-Caribbeans and all this stupid terminologies that have been put on us through slavery.
Why did you say Jesus was black?
Because he was.
How do you know that?
Because that's how he was recorded in history.
Can you...
Well, one thing at a time.
Sorry about
okay,
that.
Go on. Now, I understand, bro. You hungry, but you gotta eat one bite at a time.
I've loved you, saith the Lord.
Go on.
Yet ye say, wherein hast thou loved us?
Yep, go on.
Was not Esau Jacob's brother?
When you go into the biblical history, you had a man named Isaac, right? Now, his wife became pregnant by him, and she had 2 unidentical twins in her womb. One of them was named Jacob, one of them was named Esau. Okay, in fact, let's go straight to it. You want to get that? Genesis
25 and 21. And Isaac entreated the Lord Yahweh for his wife, because she was barren, and the Lord was entreated of him. And Rebekah, his wife, conceived. And the children struggled together within her.
The 2 children were fighting in the womb. Go on.
And she said, if it be so, why am I thus?
Go on.
And she went to inquire of the Lord. And the Lord said unto her, 2 nations are in thy womb.
2 nations are in our womb. Because nowadays, what you think of a nation is not what a nation actually is. See, Britain is not a nation, it's a corporation. That's
so
why.
What's a nation?
Good question. The word nation goes back to the word natal.
Native nationality.
Or natal. No. You know that like you get a natal word?
Yes.
Which goes back to the womb. A nation is actually a group of people that share the same lineage. It's the same thing with the word race. See, you're taught that a race is a color or certain physical characteristics, but it's not. The word race actually means a people that descend from the same lineage. So when you go into the Bible, there are different nations which are mentioned in the Bible, right? You've got Elam, Asher, Moab, Ammon, Aram, Ishmael, Edom, Israel, Put, Mizraim, Canaan, Cush, Yawan, Tarshish, Makeup.
I'm really proper interested in why I think Jesus is black.
Well, I'm going to get to that. This is all part of it, right? So you got all these different nations. Now, you got to understand that if you are descended from the man Elam, that's how you're an Elamite. You're part of the nation of Elam, okay? So what it's saying here in the scriptures is those two boys... Those two boys, they were going to grow up and become 2 nations. You understand? Okay, go on, read on.
That would mean that we're all nations.
No, because the Lord decides who becomes a nation and who don't become a nation. He decides that. Okay? Get that in Deuteronomy 32 and 8 real quick. See, that this is the Heavenly Father's program.
Deuteronomy 32 and 8. When the Most High divided the nations.
The Most High divided the nations. He decided who were going to become a nation and who weren't. Go on.
Their inheritance.
Go on.
when he separated the sons of Adam.
Because we all come from Adam, but he separated the sons of Adam into different races. Go on.
He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel.
Go on.
For the Lord's portion is his people.
Meaning the Israelites are the chosen people of the Heavenly Father, which you would be an Israelite. Okay? Now go on, let's carry on here.
And two men of people shall be separated from thy bow.
Those two nations were going to be two completely different people. They were going to have two completely different spirits on them. Okay? And that's evident today. We got our people, the so-called Negroes, Hispanics, and Native American Indians, we got a completely different spirit to the so-called white people.
It's the Rasta now, okay? The 13th tribe of Israel.
No, there's no such thing. Go on.
Rasta man.
And the one people shall be stronger than the other people.
The one people shall be stronger than the other people, man. That's talking about the Israelites. We're stronger.
That guy is off the
top. Bro, that's just Satan, man. You gotta focus on the truth.
I'm sorry.
People shall be stronger, man.
So, tell me about that.
Bro, hold on, bro. See, man, that's why we can't deal with
you. I'm jumping around. I can't ask specific questions.
No, listen, man. Listen, bro. You see what you
mean?
Hold on, bro.
I'm not being rude or anything, but I'm interested in certain things.
Yeah, but you know what,
bro? Certain things caught my eye, and that's why we're not.
Listen, man. You know what you gotta do, man? You gotta learn to focus. Okay, see, it's understandable because you've grown up in this society. And this society, you're a young lad. So you've grown up watching TV, you ain't got an attention span. But guess what? To learn the truth, you gotta focus. Even on things you're not interested in. Because you should be interested in, because I'm talking about your history. See, that's the problem with our people. They can't keep focus on anything, man. Too much distractions.
Yes, I'm not distracted, I just had specifics.
But you know what, man? This is important right here. If you can't focus on what's going on right here, then you know what, man? Go watch MTV. Go on, man.
And that's real. And the elder shall serve the younger.
The elder shall serve the younger. Yeah, go on, man. Fuck it, man. Go on, man. Let's carry on with education, man.
24.
Man, you're dismissed. You're dismissed.
Verse 24.
You're dismissed.
And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb.
There were twins in her womb.
25.
Go on.
And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment.
He came out red. Meaning what? The color was showing through his skin.
And they called his name Esau.
Yeah, they called his name Esau. Okay, which that's the progenitor of the so-called white man today. But you see, man, look, man, that's pearls anyway. That is a pearl of understanding, man. Okay, so let's go back. See, that proves what we're saying about the spirit. See, a guy like that, man, the spirit ain't dealing with him, man. So when I was speaking just then, it was just words. It was just words. And that's what's wrong with these little Negroes, man. They can't concentrate on anything. They don't have any attention span. No, what's that color there? They're like little children, man. They need to grow up. A man is supposed to be able to focus, man.
That's right.
Women can't concentrate on one thing.
That's right.
A man is supposed to be able to focus on something that's serious, man, for longer than a minute. But these young Negroes, man, they can't focus on anything for longer than a minute. A minute, that's their attention span. Oh, change the channel. The only thing they can watch for longer than that is a damn music video, and that's because there's all kind of crazy shit going on in the music videos. Hey, you ever watch the music videos nowadays? They ain't even no storyline to it. It's just crazy. A rabbit jumps out the window, then you see a shark jumping out the water. That's why these young little Negroes are messed up in the mind. They got an attention span of a goldfish, okay? He couldn't stay for 3 minutes to answer one question. That's why they're going to be killed, man. Go on, bro. The spirit ain't dealing with them. That's it on that, man. Let's go back into the spirit, man.
Right.
Where was we? It was 2 Corinthians 10 and 4. Someone had revelations about something as well. Get back on that. You know, these young little Negroes, man. Yeah, little Negroes. Nigglets, man. You know? He ain't gonna get this, man. When the cracker came up, he just wants to fucking have a fucking joke, man. They just wanna laugh. They wanna be entertained. It's like that movie, Idiocracy, man. When they just sit there watching TV all day of a guy getting hit in the balls. You niggas are jokers, man. You little Negroes, man, you're gonna have to get serious when that martial law comes. Ain't gonna be nothing funny when your mom gets shot in the face.
Come on.
That's why the elites laugh at you niggas, because they know that they can hide everything from you, because if it takes longer than a minute, you niggas are just going to get bored and you're going to just forget about it.
They study you, man.
Niggas are simple as all hell.
I got the one you said.
Oh, wait, go on, bro. Bring it up.
Revelations 3 and 19.
Go on.
And as many as I love, I rebuke and chasten.
That's right.
Be zealous, therefore, and repent.
Hey, that asshole wasn't going to be zealous about anything, man. The only thing he... Man, that's why, man, to hell with 2/3 of our people, man. They can't, you can't save a nigga like that. Hey, the word educate means to bring out. That dude didn't have nothing to bring out of him, man. He was an MTV vessel. Go on, man.
Right.
It says, see, if Jay-Z was out here rapping, he would have been like... He would have been all
diamond.
He would recite the whole lyric tape. It could be a 10-minute freestyle. He'd be there reciting the whole thing. But yeah, we're here breaking down the scriptures. No, I don't. No, I just want to know about that and this and that and that and this and, you know. Why you niggas, man? No focus, man. And what's focus? Focus is fire concentrated, man. You know. the Hindus ain't sharp, they're not lasers, man. Go on, bro.
Right. It says, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, yep, I will come into him.
Yeah, his spiritual mind wasn't open to this word. That's why when we were speaking, it didn't interest him. If you're a man of the Lord, it don't matter what topic brothers are speaking about, you're gonna be patient. You're gonna wanna learn this whole truth, man. Oh, what? Did he? Hold on, did you just say I'm of the chosen people of God? Hey, look, let me hear. He didn't even care. Like,
I just want to know how to deal with color.
He wanted something simple, and even if we broke it down to him, he weren't going to get it. He wanted something controversial. No, Jesus is black. You know? Man, he's a coon, and there's an epidemic of that. And who raised these little coons? These fucking black women, man. Okay? Little coons, man. Little I'm a jerk type little niggas, man. And niggas are gonna be stomped out when that martial law comes, man.
That's right. Oh, man. That's right. It says, and I'll come into to him and will sup with him, and yeah, he with me. To him that overcometh,
I will sup with him and him with me, meaning the Lord is gonna communicate with you spiritually, and you start getting understanding of these scriptures, man. But these scriptures are spiritual, man. It's not just a book, man. Hey, you could burn all the Bibles. You think that's going to stop prophecy? Hey, you know? That ain't going to stop it. That ain't going to stop anything. Because the Spirit of the Lord is working in this place, man. You got 2 Corinthians?
Yeah. This is 2 Corinthians 10 and 4.
Get 6 and 63 already in.
2 Corinthians chapter 10 verse 4. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
The weapons of our warfare are not carnal. You understand? We out here to teach this word. Don't you know we're laying down heavy shellings on Babylon, man? Hey, like one brother said that time, shell down the beast. Yeah? Badness, man. That's what we're doing out here. We're dropping bombs. Don't you know every time we prophesy, the Lord sends more death angels down here to destroy the place? We prophesy, the Lord not only wakes up the elect, but this kingdom gets degraded and destroyed more and more.
Right?
And it's happening before your eyes, but you people can't see it. A hurricane here and there, an earthquake here and there, a volcano exploding here and there. Those are all happening because the Spirit of the Lord is making it happen, man. Because we're prophesying this word, man. This word has force.
You just had an earthquake this morning, man. In fucking Naples, them Elamites, them Indian bastards, been living off riches for years. Now they're getting fucked up over there. Thousands of them just dead.
That's right.
Buried under rubble, buildings and shit.
We're shaking the foundations of this place. And what's the foundation in this place? Witchcraft and lies, man. Deception. That's why we're coming out here with that truth. Bring it out, my brother.
2 Corinthians 10 and 3. For though we walk in the flesh,
that's spiritual,
we do not war after the flesh.
That's right. We ain't out here. You know, brothers get it in. We do a little thing, but we ain't believing we gonna come out here and destroy Babylon doing some double jabs on a hook. That ain't gonna do nothing to Babylon. We come out here, you bring out Job 9 and 24, shakes the foundation of this place, messes up these people's spirits, man. Demons start fleeing, man. They get weak. see how them demons scattered at the name of the Lord, man? Don't you know the Lord is putting the fear on these people out here of the men of the Lord, man? That's why a lot of you scoffers don't want to come down here and confront us, man. Because you're scared, man. You hold the Revelation to the 11th chapter, man. You ain't got the balls to come down here, man. Hey, the elites are scared. They don't really want to put their hands on us, man.
That's why the police, when they come out here,
they were scared, man.
And even you had the, remember those, you had the main woman, she come down.
Yeah.
And she was like, she basically said, don't touch them, pray for me.
She said that, man. Yeah, that happened. She's the chief constable or whatever for this whole area, man. Yeah, she came down and she said, and then the other guy wanted to put his hands on us. And she shut his ass down, man. He had to tuck his little tail between his legs and flee. Hey, why? Because we're not, that's why it's important. When you come out here on the street, this ain't a personal thing, man. Stay in the scriptures, man. Stay in the spirit, man. Keep bringing these scriptures out, man. This ain't us just coming out here venting, man. This is really the spirit of the Lord, man.
For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal.
That's right. Go on.
But mighty through Yahweh Bar Shaviah with Shai.
That's right!
To the pulling down of stronghold.
The pulling down this stronghold right here. Because this is a spiritual stronghold that the elites have over the people. Because don't you know, before they do anything, they send up sacrifices and prayers unto Satan. Don't you know they do blood sacrifices anytime they do something, like an election? Don't you know you've got an election coming up? Don't you know that they've already done blood sacrifices to decide what is the best course of action, which party should go into power next? Don't you know the elites have got witches and warlocks? In fact, get me that in Isaiah, the 47th chapter. Don't you know they do sacrifices, okay? And they read the stars and they do all this witchcraft to determine what the next thing is that they should do in their agenda? Don't you know that they do that? This kingdom is built off witchcraft. When they set up America, and we got a dollar. No, Posh, you got a dollar on you, brother? Alright, bro. When they set up the United States of America, they didn't just go over to America and say, oh, there's some land over here, we're going to build it. No. They actually consulted Satan, man. They had seances with demons, man. Right? That's why when they created the dollar, they got the pyramid with the all-seeing eye on there. Because America was actually a plan of the elites back then. Okay, you had Adam Weishaupt, which he was an agent of the Rothschilds, which they're all witches and warlocks. The Rothschilds have got the witch coven known as the Council of 13. They're all witches and warlocks, just like Darwin, just like Dalton. All them guys were part of the Lunar Society. They're all masons and witches and warlocks. Whenever they do any endeavor, not of us in person, please, man. That's okay. Right? That's why they set this up, man. So when they went over to America, they was consulting demons. They actually had, when they set up Washington, D.C., they did a Masonic ceremony when they set up Washington, D.C. And Washington, D.C. is all set up on Masonic lines, man. In fact, if you go to the Capitol building, on top of the Capitol building, they got a statue of Persephone, which is what? A Greek goddess. And then all the, on the walls, they got what's known as the deification. I forgot the full name, but they basically got George Washington pictured as a god with all the other Greek gods. Because it's all a ritual, and guess what? They were sacrificing you Israelites, the blood of you Israelites, to build their empire. Okay? This was all a sacrifice, lynching you. That was all sacrifices of blood. Because blood is spiritual currency. And they still do blood sacrifices to this day. Like 9-11. 9-11 was a giant blood sacrifice. So they can bring in their New World Order, which is on the dollar bill. Because that's what America was set up to do. It says here, Novus Ordo, a new Coeptus Novus Ordo Seclorum. Meaning it is established. The New World Order. That's what America was set up to do. The UN, all of that was all planned hundreds of years ago. And what do they use? Witchcraft.
That's how they cast spells over these people and blind them with demons, with the TV, with all the images. All these people have got demons on them. They've had spells casted on them.
Yeah, but thou should not steal.
All right, exit.
We had the Bible Destruction Group, same year, about December 1776. Same year, they established the Illuminati, May 1st, which we're going into May next week. And the May's a demonic fucking month, man. You got May Day for World War One or whatever.
Yeah, that's a May Sunday, yeah.
Cinco de Mayo.
Got the new elections coming up in May. So something could go down in May, man. Yeah. The demonic month, man.
And they're always doing bloods like that. That thing came out with that guy and they had on the BBC. He was a paedophile, a head of a satanic ring. And his children came out and exposed it, how they were committing child sacrifices, and they swept it all under the rug. Don't you know they're doing all kind of child sacrifices? That's how this society is run. This society is run of blood sacrifices and demons. That's why the president of America has what? An inauguration, which they had back in Rome, and the word inaugurate means to stand in the stead of demons. Basically, he takes the power of Satan upon him so he can prophesy and make things come to fruition. So when he's coming to those speeches, he's actually prophesying certain things through the spirit of demons. That's why it's called an inauguration. But the average person don't understand that, man. Get the spirit to come out and condemn these assholes, man. But we're counteracting that. we're bringing our firepower, man. We're the other side. We're the Illuminati on the right hand side, and we're dealing with the spirit side. And we're sacrificing, man. And the main sacrifice was Yahweh Shai. Yahweh Shai sacrificed himself and defeated Satan, man, 2,000 years ago. And we're using the spirit of the Lord, which the Lord is the sword. Hey, it is the great millstone that's going to destroy this place, man. Grind this place into powder, man. Hey, get me that in the book of Daniels as well. What you got? Go on, read. Oh, Isaiah 47, read that out, man.
It's Isaiah 47 and 12.
Go on.
Stand now with thine enchantments and with thy multitude of sorceries.
The multitude of their sorceries. Don't you know they got a whole city built on sorcery called Las Vegas, man? Las Vegas has got every pagan. Man, that's a. They got what? They got the pyramids there. They got the Eiffel Tower there. They just found every pagan thing you can find and put it in one place and call it Sin City. Don't you know they it is known that you could go to Las Vegas and do anything? Why do you think a lot of the elites from around the world, the super rich, go to Las Vegas? Because you could buy anything in Las Vegas. You could do anything in Las Vegas. They doing mass sacrifices over there in Las Vegas, man. Snuff films, all of that, man. You think it's all about gambling? You think it's all about gambling, man? It ain't all about gambling. Go on, man.
Wherein thou hast labored from thy youth.
From thy youth. From the beginning of the so-called white man setting up his society, he was dealing with Satan. He weren't ever dealing with Yahweh Basham, Yahweh Shai. When they go into the Catholicism, Catholicism is nothing but the worship of Ceramesis and Tammuz and Nimrod. It's got nothing to do with the Bible. Okay? So, no, the so-called white man was never a Christian. He adopted, and the funny thing is, he adopted that wickedness from our people, man. They ain't ever dealt with the truth of the Bible, man. This ain't got nothing to do with the Bible, man. Okay? The black Madonna and the child. Alright? They were always dealing with Satan, man. Right? Them so-called Puritans, they were dealing with Satan. They were witches and warlocks. Alright? Go on.
If so, be thou shalt be able to profane it.
Right?
If so, be thou mayst prevail.
Right, they can upset the prophecy. Because prophecy is spiritual, man. Because what you people don't understand is everything that goes on, basically, this is like a movie, but everything that goes on in a movie, you got a director directing it. You got guys that come to the actor and say, look man, this is what you got to do, and then he goes and does it. That's how this world works. You got spirits that work behind the scenes in this world, making everything happen and occur. So this is a spiritual thing. That's why you can't come up against the flesh. You can't fight against the spirit. Whatever the spirit declare, that's what's going to happen. It's the fate. So they're trying to upset the prophecy, but they can't upset the prophecy. The prophecy is going to come to pass. Go on.
13. Thou art wearied in the multitude of the councils.
Multitude of, man, don't you know they have all kind of councils and witches, covens, praying against the Lord and against the return of the Heavenly Father's Son, man?
That's why you be trying to sleep and demons be trying to jump on you, man. This is a spiritual battle, man. But they can't stop this truth. Go on. Yeah, that's it. Bring this out. That's beautiful.
Ephesians 4 and 12. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood.
We're not really out here wrestling against, like when them demons came up earlier, that guy that came up earlier trying to step into the brother, that was really a demon. That was a demon that jumped on him to come up against this word. First of all these people have got demons on them. That's why they go shopping in Topshop and buy stuff they don't need. They got demons on them. That's why they do stupid things that don't make no sense. That's why they buy Coca-Cola. Why the hell would you drink Coca-Cola, man? Coca-Cola is poison. Why the hell would you drink Coca-Cola, man? You're better off drinking water. But you know why they drink Coca-Cola? Because the owners of Coca-Cola sacrifice babies, man, and send out that witchcraft. That's why Coca-Cola is one of the biggest companies in the world. And they push that Christmas. They got everyone thinking that Santa Claus. First of all, Santa Claus is a fabrication of the Coca-Cola company. You know, that whole image of Santa Claus goes back to Coca-Cola. They're working witchcraft on these fools, man. And they got demons on them. Hey, I had demons on me. Hey, for the longest time, I'm going to KFC or something to get some chicken. And the woman will be like, what drink do you want? And I hate Coca-Cola. And I'll go, Coke. I don't want Coke. It's that demon, man. Right? All these different companies, man, they push out demons out there on their products. That's why you got people killing themselves over Jordans. Because they got demons on them. iPhones. People will kill people over iPhones. They'll line up for days to get an iPhone. A phone, a mobile phone. That does the same thing as, and ain't even a great phone. Because they got demons on them. They worship that. Because that guy, Dot Jobs, he was a Satanist, man. And the first Apple computer cost $666.66, man. And he's got the symbol is the apple that's bitten, which represents the forbidden fruit in the garden. They're a bunch of demons, man. Go on, man. See, that's the reality of this world. But the elites, they know that. They know that to accomplish anything in the world, you gotta have the spirits behind you. All these celebrities, they commit sacrifices and they walk around with amulets, sex magic amulets on their bodies and talismans. Obama's got a rabbit, I believe it's a rabbit foot that he went and got from a magi over there in India. They deal with witchcraft, man. But you average everyday people, you're peons, you don't know about the spiritual realm. Man.
Matthew 4 and 8. Again, the devil taketh him up into an exceeding high mountain, and showeth him all the kingdoms of the world, and the glory of them, and saith unto him, all these things will I give thee, if thou wilt fall down and worship me.
Go on.
Then said Yahushua unto him, get thee hence, Satan.
Yep.
For it is written, thou shalt worship Yahweh, the power, and him only shalt thou serve.
That's right, because right now this world is ruled by the spiritual demon Satan. If you want to get anywhere in this world, you got to be wicked. If you want to become rich, become a pedophile, become a homosexual, murder people, kill. You got to become rich. Hey, give me the scripture. Someone get that scripture. The wicked are on all sides when the vilest men are exalted. First of all, guys like Richard Branson's, they sacrifice babies. All your celebrities on TV, they sacrifice babies. They kill their family members to get riches. That's how they get there.
That's the common denominator.
Yep.
All the celebrities.
That's
you always
right.
Check their family. One of their family members died.
Get put to death. Yeah. Like you get these guys in X Factor, and these idiots sit there watching X. First of all, X Factor is so demonic. You actually watch that program. It's so demonic. It's unbelievable. It's all about sex. Man's on there actually wearing demonic clothing with demonic makeup on. Full of a bunch of transvestites and homosexuals and lesbians, okay? And people think that they go on them shows and all they gotta do is exhibit some talent and they gonna get money. Don't you know they gotta sleep with all the producers? Don't you know they have to do sacrifices to get that record deal?
How about, you know,